वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी फोर्स मेजरमेंट। लेट अस फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज फोर्स। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू मैकेनिक्स, फोर्स इज एनी एक्शन दैट टेंड्स टू ऑल्टर और मेंटेन द मोशन ऑफ अ बॉडी और डिस्टॉर्ट्स इट। सो दस फोर्स कॉजेज चेंज इन द मोशन और चेंज इन द शेप। Force is a vector quantity, meaning it has magnitude as well as direction. Now the obvious question is, why to measure force? Why at all? So in engineering applications, we have to measure the weight of an object. In cases of vehicle, the airbag of the vehicle must be opened after a certain minimum amount of force is applied. As in case of accidents, then during the testing of materials. Now in mechanical engineering, there are various tests like the tensile test, compression test, shear test, bending test, hardness test, wherein force is applied, a certain quantity of force is applied, and the force is measured also. Then coming to the related concept. Next concept of torque. Torque is nothing but force multiplied by the perpendicular distance. Now again, we need to measure torque in case of engine, IC engines, diesel engine, petrol engine, two-stroke, four-stroke. The torque developed by the electric motor. Also, the torque has to be measured during the testing of members under torsional load. Then power. Power is calculated from the torque. Thus, to find out the power of an engine, we have to measure its torque, and to measure the torque, we have to measure the force. So all these concepts are related for measurement. Here BHP, brake horsepower of engine. Therefore, force and torque and power measurements are useful in power plants, wherein there are engines, there are turbines, IC engines, properties of materials. In case of sports, in case of ergonomics, ergonomics is a study of man-machine interface, wherein during the ergonomics, while designing an equipment, the capabilities of human being are taken into consideration, like the force applied by a normal human hand that is considered while designing a hand pump, and so on. Thus, force measurement, torque measurement, power measurement is an important aspect in mechanical engineering. Now we will see the methods of force measurement. In the first method, we can see mechanical balancing. It involves the use of simple lever, equal arm type of simple lever, unequal arm, the platform balance, and the pendulum balance. In second general method, force is converted into displacement. Convert the force into displacement and you measure the displacement. Spring balance, cantilever beam, axial beam, proving ring. These are the few examples of converting force into displacement. In a third method, convert force into pressure and then you measure the pressure. Hydraulic load cell, pneumatic load cell, use this kind of methods. In the fourth type, the force is converted into electric signal and measure the electric signal to measure the force. This uses the transducer to convert force into electrical signal. Now let us study the equal arm balance. The principle of equal arm balance is balancing of moments of a known force with the unknown force. So basically equal arm balance consists of a lever which is supported exactly at the center by fulcrum. At one end of the lever, a known mass m1 is attached, and that at the other end, unknown force which is to be measured is applied. At the fulcrum, a pointer is present at the center, and there is a scale to indicate zero or null deflection, zero position of the beam. Now, how does this work? To measure the unknown force is applied at one arm of the beam, and due to the unknown force, the beam will be disbalanced, thus the pointer will move in one direction, and the mass m1 is adjusted such that the beam becomes horizontal and the pointer shows zero deflection. So when the beam is balanced, the moment about the fulcrum are equal. Therefore, we can write moment due to the mass m1, acceleration due to gravity, and the length of arm L from the point of application of moment to the fulcrum is equal to moment due to force F and distance L between the fulcrum and the force. Now, because the distance L on both sides of the fulcrum is same, therefore it will get cancelled, and therefore the unknown force is equal to the known mass and g, acceleration due to gravity. Now let us discuss the sensitivity of the equal arm balance. In the picture you can see the schematic of an arm which is used in equal arm balance. The point F indicates the fulcrum or the point about which the arm rotates. Point G is the center of gravity of the arm. W1 and W2, these are the points where the known and the unknown force is applied. So here at the W2, here we can write unknown force is applied. These two points are at a distance L from the fulcrum, and small d is the distance between point F and point G. That is, small d is distance between the fulcrum support and G is nothing but the center of gravity of the arm. Now, the sensitivity can be defined as the angular deflection per unit of the unbalance. Here, unbalance is nothing but the difference between the two weights or two forces, that is W1 and W2. Therefore, we can write sensitivity as theta upon W1 minus W2. Now, at the equilibrium, when we solve the, when we apply the law of moments and we solve it, what we get is sensitivity is equal to length L of the arm. This is the length L of the arm divided by the product W into D, where W is nothing but the weight of the arm
and d, small d is nothing but the distance between the fulcrum and the center of gravity. Therefore, what we can see here is that sensitivity depends only upon the length of the arm, the weight of the arm, and the distance between the fulcrum and the center of gravity. It does not depend upon the force or W1, W2 which is to be measured. Therefore, to increase sensitivity, we have to make the length L of the arm as large as possible, decrease the weight of the arm, and decrease the center of distance between the center of gravity and the fulcrum. Now, this equal arm balance is very simple in construction. It has a major disadvantage that for balancing of the beam, the same amount of weight is required. Now, therefore, for heavy forces or heavy unknown weights, a same large amount of weight is required for balancing. Thus, if the unknown force is large, we have to use a large weight to balance, and that is a major disadvantage or limitation of the equal arm balance.